Fru Kirsch.
Life is too short to be drinking shitty beer.
Welcome to another edition of Bears, Bikes and Booze Reviews. Got another beer from Germany. This is a bit different. It's from a particular region in Germany, and that region is Cologne. And this beer, or this beer style, Kirsch, is only peculiar to Cologne. Now, I spoke to a German mate about this, and he reckons this is for girls. I don't care. It's 4.8%. It's in a 500 milliliter bottle. Everything's in fucking German. How dare they? How dare they write everything in German? Anyway, as I say, this is a beer style. It's a sort of lager, from what I've sort of gleaned from the research that I've done. There's the cap. Now, it's a really nice cap because it's full colour, it's bold, and it's got everything you need to know on the cap. And that's going into the collection. What have we got on the nose? Oh my good God, what is going on here? That smelled so weird. It smelled like an old Italian lorry driver's sock. Not that I've smelt one on him. Oh, there's a little bit of malt coming through here now. But that smell, oh, it's like proper sulphur, that was. Let's get it into the glass and stop making jokes about Italian lorry driver's socks. Now, I really don't know what to expect here. I've been told it's quite similar to a lager, but it's got other things going on with it as well. And there it is in the glass, and it looks very much like a lager. There's a lot of carbonation on that. I don't know if you can see that or not. It's a light straw colour, which is what's common to this style of beer. Now, I should point out the difference between this and normal German lager. This is brewed with top fermenting yeast. What does that mean? Well, top fermenting yeast is brewed at higher temperatures. Usually, the way ales are brewed, stouts, IPAs, you know, all that sort of style, they're all brewed with top fermenting yeast, which means they're brewed at a higher temperature. Bottom fermented means, you know, usually your lagers are all bottom fermented and they're brewed at a slightly lower temperatures. I haven't got the exact figures, but I've gone through this on another video that I've done. The difference with this is brewed with top fermenting yeast, but it's stored like you would a lager, which sounds really intriguing to me. Now, apparently Cologne is the only place that's done this, and the reason they've done it is it goes way back in history, I think to the, is it the 1600s or 1680s or something like that. Anyway, a good long time ago, all the brewers were getting sort of threatened by the people who are brewing, you know, bottom fermented lager, and that was becoming really popular. So in Cologne they passed a law that you had to brew with top fermenting yeast, but it was stored in the same way that lager was, and the result is Kirsch, and it's only ever brewed in Cologne. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, the EU have given that geographical protection, which means that if you want to call your beer Kirsch, or Kirsch, as it's pronounced in German, it has to be brewed in Cologne. There's a lot of people imitating this style, and apparently in America this is sort of taking off as well. There's American brewers that are doing this style. And it is a novel idea, you know, getting top fermenting sort of ale yeast, if you like, and brewing it and then storing it like you would a lager. So, this is the result. It could be shit, it could be good. Never tasted it. Wish me luck. Wow. That's really nice. And again, you've got them fantastic German malts. You can just tell German malt. It's so bready and biscuity. You know, it's big and it just dominates. I mean, there's obviously hops in this, but with this stuff, to be honest, it does taste very much like a lager, which you would expect from, you know, a beer that's been stored, you know, for a long time. All the diacetyl has just been eaten away and it's been, you know, it's super clear like that, you know. When you first drink it, there is a really, really slight sourness to it. That's what I'm getting. And that sort of remains all the way through. But you can just taste them huge malts, you know, German malt, sweet, biscuity, bready malt that just fucking washes over you. The hops in this, I mean, there obviously are, but I'm getting slight sourness from the yeast on the aroma, but I'm getting a fair amount of malt as well. But when you drink it, it's just, oh, it's an experience, believe me. Hmm. It's really good. My mate was trying to put me off this. I don't know whether it's because it's Cologne and he's from, where is it? Munster Lager, I think he's from. I don't know whether there's a rivalry. Don't care. I think Frankfurt and Cologne are the ones that have the rivalry. But this stuff, it's got everything good about German lager. It's got them amazing German malts that you get with the Bavarian Helles and I think most Helles beer that comes from Germany, you get that big biscuity bready malt, and that's evident here, but there's also a tinge of sourness to it too. I mean, it's not big at all, it's very subtle, but it is there. I think to the untrained palate, that would just be a really nice lager. And for all intents and purposes, you could argue that it is a lager because it's stored in the same way. It's just not brewed in the same way. It's used using the top fermented yeast. But the end result, I mean, to be honest, does it matter? The end result, it's just a supremely drinkable, really nice lager. I'd like to call it a lager, but it's not. It's a Kölsch. So I'm not going to try and sort of, you know, call it something it's not. But it has got them lovely German malts that make me love German beer, and especially German lagers. I mean, good German lagers have got this. The Augustiner Helles has got this. That Berliner Pilsner has got this as well. The Flensburger that I tried, that's also got it, but that's got some quite dominating, well, it was a Pilsner, so it's got the Saaz hops that are sort of dominating that, giving it an earthy, bitter sort of flavour to it. But this is all, this really is all sweetness and light, because it's straw coloured, good amounts of carbonation on that, really nice mouthfeel, but just so Moorish. I love that. I absolutely love it. And you know what? I'm going to have to give that a 10 out of 10. You know, I love all my beers. I love my stouts. I love the ales. I love the IPAs and all that. But you just cannot beat a good German beer. You know, whether it be Altbier, whether it be lager, whether it be the Helles stuff they're brewing. And now I've just found Kölsch. Apparently this isn't even the best one. There's other styles as well, so I'm definitely going to be trying that again. That's 10 out of 10, and I definitely recommend this. If you like your Bavarian beers, if you like your Augustiner Hells and all that, and if you like the the craft brewed lagers you get in there, this pisses all over a lot of them, and it's really nice. Really good stuff. 10 out of 10, recommended. And remember, like this, beer is working class champagne.